What's up, everyone? I'm Carlos Brooklyn Fragrance Lover. I'm here with my good friend Stephen from Red Lessons.
Hey,
how are you, buddy?
Good. Thank you for having me on.
My pleasure. He and his wife came over. We had some Chinese food, and we decided to do a couple of reviews. I just got this one, so we're going to do a review together for you.
Awesome.
Have you smelled this before?
No, not until I came here.
Awesome. Yeah. Well, I smelled it in December. I was looking for it for quite a few months last year, but it was only available in Europe, I believe.
Oh, okay.
This is Jean-Paul Gaultier Le Male Essence du Parfum.
Mm-hmm.
And, it was released last year, and it became available in New York City. I saw it at Bloomingdale's.
Okay.
I put it on my skin, and I was nice. I let it sit on my skin, and I had to go back. I went back a week later, and I picked it up. This is one of those that just, like,
yeah.
I couldn't get it out of my head. It actually was that good to me that I put it on my year-end list of favorite perfume releases of 2016.
Wow.
So,
okay.
Yeah. So this was released in 2016. It was composed by Quentin Bisch.
Mm-hmm.
Are you familiar with his work?
None that come to mind right
yeah,
away.
I've heard the name somewhere, but
he has an impressive resume. Yeah.
And it comes in two sizes. This is a 2.5-ounce bottle, which goes for $86, and there's a 4.2-ounce bottle that goes for $106. And look how large this is. The can
looks much bigger than
it's like
than
a humongous can.
Yeah.
Yeah. So the notes for this guy are cardamom, citrus, lavender, leather, woods, and custis root. Now,
okay.
You just sprayed it on your hand. It smells amazing on you.
It does.
I was like, wow, that's, yeah. It might even smell better on you than on me. What do you get from it?
Man, first things first, it's very sweet. It's not like
ultra mild
sweet.
It's not ultra mild sweet.
No, not at all. Yeah, so it's kind of weird because I think, I was a little hesitant. There was a little trepidation when I found out that, you know, Francis Kurkdjian is not the perfumer behind some of the newer
mm-hmm.
releases. Like, I know he did Tarib and Le Beau Mal, but once Ultramal came out...
And the original, of course, yeah?
Yes, of course,
okay.
The original. But with Popeye, it was a different perfumer. He,
I
to
like
my
Popeye.
Knowledge, he did do Ultramal. He did not do Popeye. It was a female fragrance reviewer, fragrance composer. I forget her name now. But so it kind of took me by surprise that this one is Quentin Bisch, but it's a really wonderful scent.
It smells really good. I don't get that much sweetness on my skin, but I definitely get like leather. It has character.
Yeah.
I definitely get lavender. I don't recall the original Le Male. It's been a long time since I smelled it. So can you get the comparison to the original or has nothing
so,
tied to it?
I mean... So far, no. This one is much sweeter than the original.
Mm.
I know they always talk about the lavender, the mint, the vanilla. With the original, when it dries down, I get like the soil note. It smells like this sort of kind of dirty patchouli. This one is, it looks like it took off in a very different direction. And it's a different perfumer. It's a totally different note breakdown. So it's pretty interesting that this is kind of a flanker, you know, similar presentation. It's a little more...
And if I remember correctly, I think Le Male has like a zillion flankers, right?
Yeah.
Through the years.
Yeah, definitely.
I mean, it takes the record for being one of the most made flankers of a fragrance for sure.
Yeah.
I think it was like 20-something, if not more.
I know. I think it is more. And they have a lot of collector's editions. So I think that's kind of misleading. You know, you go to the store and you're like, oh my God, they came
and
out
the
with a Sailor Le Male or whatever.
Yeah.
And it'll be the same exact thing. But I know people who collect it and, you know, to each his own. I think that's really cool.
I think the bottle is hot.
Yeah.
I really love this bottle.
I think it looks a lot cooler than the original.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Than the blue with the stripes.
Yeah. The stripes, the nautical theme is pretty cool. But I like that they switched it up a little bit. It's a little more chiseled. It does remind me of CH Men Privé. Yeah.
You have CH.
I do.
On your mind. Lately.
Yeah, I know. The funny part is we just finished doing a video and I made a comparison between the fragrance that we reviewed and CH Men.
Mm-hmm.
This one reminds me of Privé, where it has that sweetness. There's like a leathery quality in there too. You said you picked up on a little bit of lavender. I would say the lavender note is a little bit stronger in the original. This
yes,
one, it's
for sure.
Kind of like, it's resting in the background, but it's still there. It has a presence. It's
and
not overbearing.
And cardamom is clearly in this composition.
Yeah.
I smell the cardamom, and I love cardamom as
yes.
a note.
Yep.
I've heard somebody mention on one of the Facebook groups that all they got from this was cardamom. I don't agree, but
yeah.
That's what he said. Now, this doesn't project immensely. It's kind of like one of those like pretty close to the skin scent clouds, but it lasts for a long time.
A lot of base notes, yeah.
You know, it's one of those that you're not, it doesn't walk into the room before you, absolutely not. But when you walk by people, they definitely get a nice trail of you. I like this one a lot. I'm happy I picked this up.
Yeah.
I'm going to get some good wear out of this for sure.
Yeah. You know, this is something that I would put in my collection very quickly. So it did come out last year, right?
Yeah.
So it's a little too, you know, because I think it would have certainly made my list, mm-hmm. my top 10 of 2016. It's a little too late now, but it definitely would have made my list. Like, I really hold this to high regard. I think it's a really good scent. And sure. It's a pleasant, you know, turn of events for the Jean Paul Gaultier house, because I know, you know, they've had this reputation of just releasing so many different flankers. And I know Lamal Tarib was like one of the first flankers, and people thought it was just that terrible.
that's so messed up when that happens. Like, what was one that came up? Diesel Bad. Everybody didn't like that one either.
Yeah, I know. So, I mean, at least with this company, all of the flankers that they have been coming out with have been pretty solid flankers.
Yes.
And they deviate enough from the original to warrant a purchase. And I think that that's something that people hold in high regard.
From what I vaguely remember of the original is like real loud. Loud lavender, loud mint, and it's kind of like a clubbing type of scent, perhaps?
It is a clubbing scent, yeah, for sure.
You know, so, and that's a long time. I remember a coworker wore it, and like I would always smell it when he was around, for mm-hmm. sure.
Yeah.
You know, but there are some that enjoy that. This is definitely on the quieter side, but not a skin scent, so don't get it twisted there.
Yeah.
So, yeah, this is our review, Stephen and I, of Le Male Essence de Parfum, and hope you enjoyed. Thanks for watching. Thanks for being on it.
You know, thank you for having me. I really appreciate it. And thank you for introducing me to another really, really good scent.
My pleasure.
It's always refreshing when you hear so much about a fragrance and you look on Fragrantica and you watch the YouTube reviews and you're like, man, I really want to try this.
On Fragrantica, I don't recall, it wasn't too positive. There was a lot of negative.
Oh, really?
On the from what I read, I believe. I could be wrong, but I distinctly remember seeing, you know, and of course they have the giving it ratings before it's even out on the market. That happens all the time over there.
Yeah. Yep.
All right.
Yep.
So you guys know where to find this guy. I'll leave the link if not. And hope you're all well. And we'll see you at the next review.
Take
care. Take it easy. He and the wife came over and we had a few things to eat. No drinking today. We are sober.
Yeah.
Squeaky clean Friday.
Not a good feeling. I'm just kidding. It's a great feeling.
It's Le Male Essence de Parfum. What is it called?
Essence de Parfum.
Essence du Parfum?
Essence du Parfum.